Hi everybody, welcome to the Ultimate DevOps Git course from Git to Start with Muhammad Fathi. We have Git installed. The next step is a little bit of configuration. We have to tell Git who we are so that it can record that along with the information it records about the code. For example, we have here three developers, Muhammad, Ali, and Ahmed. For example, if the Muhammad here writes some code or make a change on this file and push it, so it will be records in the database. So the changes here, so it will be get add this change. For example, adding some line of code, it will be records in a database along with that the name of the developer. So this made this change, Muhammad. So along with the change, it will be a change stored also the name or the identity of the developer. So this what happened. So how we tell Git who we are. So let me open the terminal. You can open Git bash on Windows, or you can open terminal on Mac or Linux. So this is a terminal. You can let me 2 minutes to or 1 minute to explain the first command. So this is a get command. Get command here, and we need to add a sub command. So get config. So this is a sub command. Config is a sub command. And we need to add flags. So the flag here like dash dash system or dash dash global. So this is called a flag. So we need to tell Git who we are by typing the, you can for example make this git config name, user.name between double quotes. You can write for example Muhammad Fathi and press enter. It will bring an error, so not a git repository, because this will save this information in local. We don't have a local repository, so you can save a configuration file in three levels. So let me go to the presentation. This is our presentation. You can save the git information on three levels. The system level, so the system level, it will be saved to all users. For example, if you have more than one user on your computer, so the information will be for the all users. Also, you can save the information global. So global means all repositories of the current user, and this information will be stored in the your home directory in the file .gitconfig. The system configuration, it will be saved in etc /.gitconfig. Also, you can save your configuration local at the current repository. It will be for the current repository, and it will be the repository .git in the file called config. So we will make initiate or we will initiate a new project, and you can see this .git and config file. So let me go to the terminal here, and here I am gonna use this type the name by adding here the global flag by typing here dash dash global, so and press enter. So here we need to have an error. So this global here, I am so sorry, this global here, it should be before the name. So git config dash dash global and press enter. Now the name will be saved. You can also save the here. You can also save the email editor, the default editor. So let me save the email by git config dash dash global user dot email, Here the you can type email like this, for example, code to start at gmail.com between double quotes, or you can remove the double quotes because here the name not contains any space. So you can remove this if you like. So if you press enter, now the email will be saved. Also, you can save the default editor. The default editor, it will be Vim or V. If you want your default editor, for example, to be VS Code, you can add this by typing here the type this command. So here, git config dash dash git config core dot editor equal between double quotes code mean the VS Code. Here I can open the VS Code by typing code, because code is added to the global or to the path variable. So I can open VS Code by typing code and press enter. It will be open the VS Code as you can see. So let me close this. And here I'm gonna add the global editor to be my VS Code. So by git config global dash dash global core dot editor equal between double quote, I'm gonna here type code dash dash wait. Wait means here to VS Code. This terminal will be waiting VS Code until VS Code to be closed. So this terminal will be waiting the VS Code. So press enter. Now, if you want to open this configuration, I can type here git config dash dash global and dash e and press enter. So here hit waiting for editor close file. So not found. We have a problem with the double. So we have error here. So we need to remove the equal. So here this, I'm gonna remove this equal and press enter. So now if you type git config dash dash global e and press enter, it will open the configuration by the VS Code. So you can read our configuration like the user here. We have a name and email. You can also edit this. For example, you can edit the email, for example, Muhammad, and control. You can save this, and if you close, and here you can print, as you can see here, the you can, if you type here git config dash dash global e, so that this terminal will be waiting. If you open this terminal, this terminal will be wait VS Code until to be closed. So you can see the name is called the email is called Muhammad. So if you closed VS Code, so here the terminal, the git will be get back. So I'm gonna here you can show the email by type here git user dot email and press enter. So I'm so sorry, we need to add git config user dot email and press enter. Here the email will be Muhammad at gmail. So you can also make the color. So you can add the color. So the color will be more clear when you work with the diff. So in upcoming lecture. So let me add the color here. So by git config dash dash global color dot UI and add it to true. So when I type git diff and press enter, it will show me the output in color. So This will be as we it will be clear as we discussed in upcoming lectures. So also let me talk about how Git handle the ending of lines. So this is very, very important topic. So it will be it will be important for many developers. So let me here in Windows Git handle the end of line using the line feed and the carriage return. So let me open this. So if this Muhammad work on Windows, and here when he type any line, the end of line will be marked by line feed and also by carriage return backslash r and backslash n. So when Muhammad push this changes to the git should remove the carriage return. So it will be remove this carriage return. The only one will be the align feed. So it will be saved or stored here without carriage return. The only line feed will be on the repository. So for example, when this person pull, it will pull this with the line feed. Also, if this Linux or Mac will be end of line will be marked by the line feed, not carriage return. If this by mistake this computer contains by mistake carriage return, so we need to tell Git to remove this when store this to the Git. So when store to the Git, we need to remove the carriage of if it exists. How we can do this? We can do this on Mac by this property. So this property called the core.autocrlf. Auto C short for carriage return line feed. So carriage return line feed. You can do this in Windows by git config dash dash global core.autocrlf equal to true, and on Mac Windows you can git config dash dash global core.autocrlf input. So this will be true in Windows and input on Mac and Linux. You can make this. So git config dash dash global core dot auto crlf. In Windows you can assign it to true, but in Linux and Mac by the input. So and press enter. If you type git config core dot auto crlf and press enter, it will show the input. This is the end of this lecture. We will see you in the next lecture.